ChargerLAB this time got a 2-in-1 USB-C to USB-C cable from Anker. Both USB-C output cables support a charging power of 140 watts, which can meet the power requirements of MacBook Pro. In addition, it also supports intelligent power distribution such as 112 watts plus 18 watts or 50 watts plus 50 watts. So you can charge two devices with this one cable. Next, we will take this cable apart and take a look at its design. Anker and number 1 are printed on the front of the box. The box contains the cable and some documents. The USB-C input cable connector has an integrated shell with a matte surface, and Anker is embossed on the front. The two USB-C output cable connectors on the other end have the same design. The USB-C ports have a non-full pin design. The cable is woven with nylon, which is more wear resistant and durable. Anker is printed on the case at the node where the cable is divided into two. The length of the cable is about 133 centimeters. The diameter of the cable is 3.27 millimeters. The weight is about 55 grams. ChargerLAB Power ZKM003C shows that it has an eMarker chip and can support 50 volts 5 amp and USB 2.0. Let's do the voltage drop test. This test measured the difference between the input and output voltages. And this spec is an important factor in measuring the quality of the cable. From the chart, we can see that the largest voltage drop difference is 0.8 volts for 20 volts 5 amp, and the smallest difference is 0.14 volts for 28 volts 1 amp. Use one of the USB-C output cables with a 140 watts charger to charge a power bank. The real-time charging power is about 129 watts. Next, let's start to take it apart and take a look at the internal components. Firstly, cut off the USB-C input connector. It is filled with hard plastic to protect the USB-C PCB. Remove the inner plastic shell as well. The USB-C PCB is small and is only designed to connect the pins and wires. Remove the node shell, and the main components are all located on this small PCB. One side of the PCB is equipped with a PD decode chip, a protocol chip, and 4 MOSFETs. The other side is equipped with a synchronous buck converter, an alloy buck inductor, and 3 MOSFETs. The protocol chip of the two USB-C output ports is from Injoinic. It supports multiple USB ports, dual port 18 to 140 watts fast charging, independent feedback control, and independent USB PD control. The programmable PD controller is from Injoinic and adopts DFN3x3-10 package. It supports bidirectional applications of CON power supply, programmable overcurrent protection and current capability definition and detection. It supports PD 3.1 applications and uses I2C port for communication. The VBUS CC1 CC2 pins have a voltage resistance of 28 volts. The 4 MOSFETs from VGSEMI are of the same model and adopt PDFN3333 package. 40 volts 6.4 milliohm for each. The buck chip marked with BAX is from MPS and adopts 2.5 by 3 mm QFN-13 package. It has built-in MOSFET. It has a built-in 33 milliohm or 22 milliohm synchronous buck MOSFET and supports adjustable current limit. The alloy buck inductor is marked with 4R7. The two MOSFETs next to the inductor also come from VGSEMI. The other MOSFET that adopts PDFN3333 package is also from VGSEMI. Negative 40 volts. Cut off the cable. From outside to inside, there are braided layer, plastic layer, shielding net, shielding foil wires, and tensile wire. The red positive wire is made of tin copper wire with tensile wires inside. The negative wire core is exposed. The green wire used for USB 2.0 data transmission adopts D plus cores and also has tensile wires inside. The white wire used for USB 2.0 data transmission adopts D minus cores and also has tensile wires inside. The blue CC wire also has tensile wires inside. Disassemble the USB-C output connector, and the internal design is the same as the input connector. The welding point between the wires and the small PCB is protected by glue. Well, those are all components of Anker 140W 2-in-1 USB-C to USB-C cable. The cable adopts a braided design. It can provide 112 watts plus 18 watts or 65 watts plus 27 watts charging power for laptops and phones. When charging two laptops, it will provide 50 watts plus 50 watts charging power. After taking it apart, we found that it was designed based on the protocol chip IP2738U and the PD decoy chip IP2752 from Injoinic. The cable is equipped with a shielding net and shielding aluminum foil to prevent interference. It also has built-in tensile wires no matter in the cable or the wire cores. The overall workmanship is good. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye.